In this topic, we'll be covering a discounting payback period method. Now, we saw payback period method has certain disadvantages. Certain disadvantages in a sense, it ignores time value of money and it does not take into account if projects have unequal investments. Now, it also ignores the future cash inflows which might generate after the payback period. But discounted payback period actually came into existence to remove the major disadvantage of time value of money. This method takes into account time value of money when you start finding out as the payback period method. As you can see, the method is discounted payback. It means just take into account how fast you get back your investments. Concept remain the same. Only thing is, when you're seeing how fast you're getting back your investment, you're just going to discount your cash flows with a discounting rate. And how we use discounting rate, how we use present value, you see, saw in the first topic for this session. Concept remain the same. How fast am I getting back my money back in the business? Only difference is just discount your cash flows and then you take into consideration. How do we do that? Let's look at this illustration. Now, the company is considering investment of rupees 1 lakh, okay, in a project. The following are the income forecast. You can say for the first year is 10,000, second year is 40,000, third year is 60, and the 20,000 for the next year, right? Now, assume discounting rate is given to you as 10%, right? Find out the discounted payback period. See, if it was a normal method, you just have seen out of these profits how fast you're getting your 1 lakh back. But discounting payback means whatever inflows are given to you, discount with the present value factor. The present value factor is 10%. As I told you, you can use a present value table or you can use a calculator. What is present value? Future value divided by 1 plus r to the power n. Right now, if you have a calculator in hand, you can do it. For 1 rupee will be how much? 1 divided by 1.1, because if I have told you just now, discounting rate is 10%. So 1 divided by 1.1 press equal to sign, what will you get? 0.909. You get the discounting factor for the first year. Continue, press equal to sign again, you get 0.826 for the next year. Press equal to sign again, 0.753. Point equal to sign again, 0.683. Now, this is how you get as a discounting factors. Either you can calculate on your own or you can refer a present value table. Now, find out the present value of your cash inflows. How do you find the present value of cash inflows? Is multiply your cash inflows with the discounting factor. Remember, in the first topic, I told you how to use present value, future value into present value interest factor. So future values are what over here? Cash inflows. Multiply your cash inflows with the discounting factor, you get present value of cash inflows. 10,000 into 0.909 will give you how much? 9091. 40,000 into 0.823. Similarly, 60,000 into 0.751. You can see the next column is filled up with the present value of cash inflows. Now you see, in how many years do I get back my 1 lakh? Same thing, payback. How fast do I get back my investment? Only difference over here is that I'll just discount it first and then I'll see. So let's start. So the first year profit is 9,091. Second year, how much you got was 33,060. Now, if you add up both together, how much you get? 42,151. It means cumulative inflows of 42,151. Keep continuing. Third year present value of cash inflow was 45,078. If you add up, how much do you get? 87,229. It means 1 lakh has not reached yet. Fourth year present value of cash inflow was how much? 13,060. If you add up also, you get 1,889. It means the answer is somewhere between your third and the fourth year. Right, same as you did before in the previous illustration, same way find out the answer in years and months. 3 years is the minimum thing I'm looking for and the remaining answer will be in months. And when you solve it, that is 1 lakh minus 87,229 will be the numerator. Denominator will be 13,660. If you do it, we'll get the answer in months. And we saw it, we'll get the answer is 3 years and 9 months. It means for this investment, if I do, how much fast will I get back my money? I'll get back my money in 3 years and 9 months. Same way how you do it, continue. Okay. Only thing in discounted payback is that you just need to discount your cash flows with a present value factor and then you continue thereafter. Now, this method, as you can see, the small improvement from the previous method. Payback was a very simple method. But this method came with the improvement, you can say it takes into account time value of money. It's easy also, just how fast you get back your investment and you accept or reject based on that. Shorter the payback, I accept. Longer the payback, I reject. But this method also suffers from some serious limitations. Like, it does not take into account the inflows which happen after the payback. Similarly, it does not take into account this method when your investment's amount is different. That's why we say that discounted payback period method is also not a complete method in itself. This method led to the emerging of the next method of traditional method, that is what accounting rate of return. And the next session we'll be seeing some other methods of capital budgeting.